हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ अमनप्रीत कौर फ्रॉम गुरु नानक देव यूनिवर्सिटी एंड एम लीगल इंटर्न एट लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी। सो टुडे वी आर गोना टॉक अबाउट अबेटमेंट ऑफ एयर। सो व्हाट इज़ अबेटमेंट बाय एयर? सो अ पर्सन अबेट्स अ डूइंग ऑफ अ थिंग हु इंटेंशनली एयर्स बाय एनी एक्ट और लीगल ओमिशन द डूइंग ऑफ दैट एक्ट। सो अंडर सेक्शन 107 क्लॉज 3 इट मस्ट बी रेड विद एक्सप्लेनेशन 2 ऑफ द सेक्शन एंड इफ रेड टुगेदर इट बिकम्स क्लियर दैट अ पर्सन कैन नॉट बी हेल्ड गिल्टी ऑफ एडिंग the doing of an act when the act has not been done at all. For example, a person keeps on opening the gate of the house for the thieves to come, but the thieves never came. So in that case, we can't say that it is a case of abetment by aid, as the act has not been committed yet. So we can say that mere intention to facilitate, even coupled with an act calculated to facilitate, is not sufficient to constitute abetment unless the act which is intended to facilitate actually takes place and is facilitated thereby. So we can say that a mere giving of an aid does not make the act an abetment of an offense if the person who gives the aid does not know that an offense was being committed or contemplated. The intention should be to aid the commission of an offense, but if the person who lends his support does not know or has any reason to believe that the act which he was aiding or supporting was in itself a criminal act, it cannot be said that he is intentionally aids or facilitate the doing of the offense. Mere presence does not amount to aid. The mere presence at the commission of an offense does not amount to intentional aid unless it is intended to have the effect. To be present and appear that the offense is about to be committed does not constitute abetment unless the person so present holds some position of authority or rank or we can say influence of such a nature that he is being a crucial part in that offense. And also under the circumstances be held to direct is involved in the direct encouragement or engagement unless some specific duty of prevention rests on him which he leaves unfulfilled in such a manner that he may be safely taken as having joined in conspiracy for preparation of the offense. So we can say that the mere presence does not amount to aiding unless he's of a crucial rank or he's holding some position that can encourage the offense or without which the offense cannot be committed. Other than that, we can talk about aid by illegal omission. Aid may be rendered by act as well as by illegal omission when the law imposes on a person a duty to discharge his failure to discharge renders him liable to punishment. There was a case that is Queen versus Kali Charan. In that case, a head constable who knew that certain persons were likely to be tortured for the purpose of extorting a confession purposely kept out of the way. He was guilty of abetment within the meaning of explanation 2. In such cases, it is necessary to show that the accused intentionally aided the commission of the offense by his non-interference. So in this regard, the non-interference, where the non-interference of the of some kind of person directly encourages the other person to commit an offense, in that case also it shall be considered as a case of abetment by aid. Other than that, we must know that omission to give information that a crime has been committed does not amount to aiding unless such omission involves a breach of legal obligation. Also, there is an important aspect that is aid by act. So there was a case that is Emperor versus Faiz Hussain, and it was a case of in which a zamindar lent a house to a police officer who was investigating a case knowing that the house would be used for torturing a suspected thief. So in this case he was guilty of abetment as he knew that the house is being used for the purpose of torture or it will be used for the purpose of torture in future, and he himself provided that house with the same thought and same perspective. Also, there was a case that is Emperor versus Ramlal, in which some persons did their best to dissuade a woman from becoming a sati. They had also given information to the nearest police station, but finding it impossible to dissuade her, complied with her wishes and helped her in becoming sati. They were all held guilty in abetment. Similarly, in R versus Fretwell, an English case, the prisoner procured poison at the desire of and under threat of self-destruction by a pregnant woman. The prisoner knew that the poison was to be used for procuring abortion, but he did not administer it to the woman and nor cause it to be taken by her. He also expected that she would change her mind and not resort to it. The woman who was a pregnant took a dose of poison and died. The prisoner was held not guilty of being an accessory before the fact, because in this case he was not having any intention to be involved in that, and he was not with the purpose to aid the act. So aiding the act was not his purpose. So he cannot be guilty for the abetment by aid. Then other comes that by affording facility. The facility given must, however, be such as it is essential for the commission of the crime. If it is not essential for the commission of the crime, then it shall not be considered as that facility to be very much important, and that will not lead to abetment by aid. The mere act of allowing an illegal marriage to take place at one's house does not amount to abetment. Similarly, it was held in the Emperor versus Umi case that mere consent to be present at an illegal marriage or actual presence in it or the grant of accommodation in a house for the marriage does not necessarily constitute it in the abetment by aid. So, that is Mong Ba Yoke versus Ma Hala Kin. A motor car was so used with the knowledge of the owner or under his orders, the owner could not be held guilty of abetting abduction. Where A strikes B, who by such provocation is excited to a violent rage, we can see that in those cases, one cannot be guilty of abetment for providing the facility, as they were not having any knowledge about such. So the other important topic is about the attempt. So the abetment of an offence is itself a substantive offence. Abetment is an offence within the meaning of the term under section 40 of IPC also. Therefore, attempt to commit the offence of abetment will be well covered by the provisions of section 511 of the code. So an example of such is that if A is asking for a gun to shoot someone, and B with the same knowledge provide him with a gun that he may shoot the other person, and he is having full knowledge about it, then he shall be guilty of the abetment by aid. So this was all about abetment by aid. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, put a thumbs up on this video, and also don't forget to like and subscribe the channel Lexically. And this was for the education purpose only. This does not solicit any promotion or advertisement as per the guidelines of the Bar Council of India. Thank you.